Do you have a Facebook account or plan on creating one soon? Have you bothered to read Facebook's Terms of Service? This presentation focuses on Facebook's Terms of Service and data policy. Firstly, it is important to note these documents apply to Facebook, its services, and often its other companies. This includes the website itself, mobile apps such as Messenger and Internet.org, and to an extent, WhatsApp and Instagram. There are a number of areas which these documents focus on, and in particular, I'll be focusing on copyright and intellectual property issues, censorship, and privacy. Firstly, let's look at copyright and intellectual property. One of the first points that Facebook's Terms of Use state is that you own all the content and information you post on Facebook and you control it, closely followed by the words echoed in most social networking sites' Terms of Use policies. For content like photos and videos, you specifically give us the following permission. You grant us a non-exclusive, transferable, sub-licensable, royalty-free, worldwide license to use any intellectual property content that you post on Facebook. What does this mean? Well, basically, while Facebook can't claim to own that picture that you posted last week, they have an intellectual property license for it, which more or less gives them permission to do whatever they want with it, use it themselves, sublicense the image, transfer the image, edit the image, and just about anything else they wish. While this is a concern for most users, it is very much a common term among almost all forms of social media nowadays anyway. An issue that is arguably more important is that the terms go on to state when you delete content, it is deleted in a manner similarly to emptying a recycling bin on a computer. You understand that removed content may persist in backup copies for a reasonable period of time, but will not be available to others. Sure, that embarrassing selfie from last weekend may be off your timeline, but as far as we know, Facebook can still access it, and there is no limit on how long it may be available to them. In terms of protecting others' intellectual property rights, Facebook has strict terms. Users must not post content or do anything else on Facebook that infringes someone else's rights. Facebook also offers users a simple copyright infringement form to fill out should they believe their rights have been infringed. When we consider reporting of abuse, whether copyright or something more serious like cyberbullying, this leads us into censorship. Facebook has a number of terms in relation to censorship, which gives them the power to remove any content or information you post if Facebook believes it violates their policies, and in the event a user repeatedly infringes others' intellectual property rights, Facebook can disable their account when appropriate. These measures seem both reasonable and acceptable on paper, yet as we have seen over the last few years with a number of YouTube content creators having their videos stolen and posted on Facebook, doesn't appear as though Facebook enforces these terms very well. Not to mention, Facebook puts the onus on themselves to determine what is and isn't acceptable, and it's not a transparent process. In terms of cyberbullying, Facebook also has very strict terms. Users must not bully, harass, or intimidate any user or post content that is hate speech, pornographic, or threatening. Content must not incite violence and must not contain nudity or graphic violence. Users must not use Facebook to do anything unlawful, misleading, malicious, or discriminatory. These are definitely the key features of Facebook's terms of use, especially with the ever-growing cyberbullying epidemic. While it is still quite disconcerting that Facebook has often focused on censoring the wrong kind of content, especially considering in Facebook's principles, it is categorically stated that people should have the freedom to share whatever they want in any medium and any format, it is also alarming that even with terms like this, 73% of adult internet users have seen someone be harassed online. Speaking of disconcerting, let's move on to privacy and security. Facebook has a number of terms for registration and account security. You must not provide any false information, make more than one account, or recreate an account if it is disabled. To use Facebook, you must not be under 13, must not be a convicted sex offender, and you must keep your contact information up to date. Facebook verifies accounts with phone numbers, which must be unique, and as a result, overall, these account terms are a key feature to ensure Facebook remains a safe environment for all users. Moving on to account privacy in the terms of service, we are directed towards Facebook's data policy. To summarize the data policy, Facebook collects all of the content information you provide, potentially including locations of photos, the type of content you view, how long you engage with it, information from others about you, including photo tags or when they send you a message, and information about your friends and groups. Facebook also collects device information from all devices, including software and hardware information, GPS, Wi-Fi, or Bluetooth connections and locations, your time zone and connection information such as your phone number, IP address, and internet service provider. If you make a purchase through Facebook or an app, Facebook collects payment information such as card numbers and even has the ability to collect information from their partners and other companies, including completely unrelated sites if sites use Facebook advertising or an embedded like button. Facebook can use this information to personalize content and advertising, suggest you check into places and tell your friends if you are nearby, verify accounts and activity, and even make suggestions such as that a friend tagged you in a picture by comparing it to information from your profile pictures and other photos, almost like a form of face recognition. Facebook shares this information with other Facebook companies' services, as well as non-personally identifiable information to ad services, any statuses, posts, or content to the public depending on your individual settings, and perhaps most importantly to third-party partners, customers, and vendors, because in their own words, it makes it possible for Facebook to operate and provide free services to people around the world. Data policy also outlines what others can do, how information is deleted, and states all data is stored in the US and may be accessed for legal requests, as we'd expect. You may not care if Facebook take all your data and store it, and that's fine, but remember Facebook's two main principles for the users are the freedom to share and connect and the freedom to own and control their information. These are contradicted by a number of terms. While many of the terms are a must, especially in terms of the law, or cyberbullying and copyright, just about license our life away by logging in. This is the price we pay to use this free service. We give Facebook these permissions knowing we have legally indemnified them from any issues, with the terms of use stating we do not guarantee that Facebook will always be safe, secure, or error-free. We do our best to keep Facebook safe, but cannot guarantee it. We will continue to use Facebook because it has monopolized the world that is social media and communication, but perhaps at the very least we'll keep the words of Jones and Sultan in mind. Facebook is undermined by three principal factors. Users disclose too much, Facebook does not take adequate steps to protect user privacy, and third-party companies are actively seeking out end-user information using Facebook.